I think the most magical thing with timber is that you can build with timber. The way that timber is being made by itself, basically, growing like very large pieces of grass in the forest. It's not something that we dig out of the ground when we're sourcing it. It's still very impressive to see a building being made with timber. The project that we designed is the tallest timber building in the world. It's going to be 20 stories, and that's never been done before. In 2016, my colleague Robert Schmitz and I won the competition to design the culture center in Skellefteå, which is both a culture center with several theater stages, two art galleries, there's the city library, and then a hotel and a conference center. And they can function on their own like they did before, but also start working in new ways of collaboration and using each other's spaces. So the idea of sharing is built into the core of that project as well.
It's great to be on site because we haven't been here for a while since Corona. We've been away for 6 months almost. We've been following it online and through pictures. So it's great to be here to see it. So lots has happened. It's always very nice to see when the reality is better than what you imagined, which you can never simulate in an image or in a drawing.
So we had regulations in Sweden up until 1994 that limited the height of timber construction because of the fires that we've had historically in cities in Sweden for a very long time ago, that you couldn't build taller than two stories. Sweden is unique within the timber construction that we don't have a maximum height limit. If you can manage to design a building that's tall in timber and that stands, then you can build it.
So this is the main entrance where there's going to be a grand staircase. I think this is one of the most amazing rooms in the project because you can really feel the weight of the hotel coming down on these huge columns.
The main challenge has been getting people to accept the risk of building something that has not been built before. And people doubt timber as a construction material because they have a relationship to it when it comes to smaller buildings. And how would you use that material in something big? Will it even stand? That's one issue that many people think about. And then, of course, fire and water. Well, the thing is that when we're talking timber in tall buildings and in larger buildings, the raw material is the same, but this is engineered wood. And in case of a fire, for instance, the fire gets on the surface of the wood and it becomes black, it becomes charcoal, and it's protecting the inner layers of timber from the heat. Everyone in Sweden has a relationship to timber as a construction material. But all of the memories and the experiences that we've had is basically from our homes, a cabin in the woods or when we go skiing. So it's very intimate and personal relationships. I think that people instantly, when they enter a building made of timber, do feel a bit at home. I would say the main advantage of building in wood is the climate effect it has, that it's minimal. It's the only renewable material that we know of today for structures in buildings. I think my relationship to wood as a material has changed a lot because I've been put in a position where I can make a difference. Because now that the building is actually being realized, it gets a lot of attention. All of this attention can be used to promote sustainable construction in different parts of the world.
Det här projektet har ju handlat om arkitektur som är byggt av trä och inte trä som sen ska bli arkitektur. Jag tror inte att man har förstått vidden utav det här projektet riktigt än, utan att det kommer under invigningen, tror jag.
Once it's finished and I'm standing on the 20th floor of the building, I'm expecting to be surprised because you will have a view over the entire landscape around Skellefteå and you will feel that you're in a high rise, but you will also be in a wood cabin somehow.